quoted many times. I think it's the Minchas Alozer. It says, Mishnichnes Av, Remaikun B'Simcha. How are you, Remaik, in the Nyonim from Av, Duch Simcha? That's one of the reasons why you do this Yumim, to do the Hashem Yisrael Mesam Chalev. The Elter Yidin Hanli. What? The Elter Yidin Hanli. The Elter Yidin Hanli. The Elter Yidin Hanli. The Is to make an agor a greiser simcha, is me sech des megille, bengt an ab sa a frische simcha, the ganze inye from Purim. Is the siyem from sech des megille, perik bineo ir. Is a gamme nemes in the teishe yomte, bengt an ab fan a zirig gesoiz. Oh, I'm sorry. Yeah, the teishe yomte brings two neskoiz gesoiz, which is actually the siyem, what is actually the fourth perik of sech des megille. In Mishnah, as you see, that it's a Akeda Eimet, but over here in the Gemara, which is taken, the Rebbe made the Siyim on Bnei Yair. It's Daf Lamed Beis, Omer Apanach, Omer Rab Yochanan. Kol Oicha Sefer Torah Orum, if somebody holds a Sefer Torah Orum, means without the holding anything, whether it's Eitz Chaim or the Mitpachas, then it's Nigba Orem, because you're not allowed to hold the Sefer Torah with your bare hands. So what's the punishment? That he'll be buried naked, without Tachrichim. So the Gemara says, Orem Shalkadaitach, how is it possible such a severe punishment, Chabazoyin HaMes, they should be buried like that just because he, as important that it is, but it should not come to such a punishment. So the Gemara says, "Ela'ema nigba orum beloy mitzvahs." Means orum without mitzvahs. That all the mitzvahs that are accumulated, it's not considered anymore. So the Gemara says, "Beloy mitzvahs al kedaitach." All the mitzvahs which you accumulate for the entire life should be discredited because of the fact that he held the Sefer Torah with his bare hands. Elom rabaya nigba orum beloy oisum mitzvah. What means without that mitzvah? So Tosfos brings a mefeirish, it means with that mitzvah, with a mitzvah holding a Sefer Torah, that mitzvah you're not going to have. So Tosfos disputes and said that's chmishka chiddush. Michael Mashman, obviously, if you didn't do the mitzvah the way it's supposed to be done, you do not have the mitzvah. So Tosfos learns pshat that below eisim mitzvah, if you learn b'shas ma'aseh, you're holding Sefer Torah, you're learning that mitzvah of Talmud Torah is being discredited. Then the Gemara says, Omer Rabbiana bereid Rabbiana so mishmeid Rabbiana rabbe mutev tigol amitachas by yigol Sefer Torah. When you make hagbe or whatever in any shape or form, you want to put away the Sefer Torah, and that's how we do it. You take the Sefer Torah, you put it down, and you put the mitpachas on that. You don't put it in. You go, in those days they had the malbush, whatever it is, but the Sefer Torah is the ikir. Then the Gemara quotes the Mishnah, about the nations, mi'ad Hashem l'bnei Yisroel, mitzvos and shikain eisen kol echa bizmane. The Mishnah brings all the kriyas ha-Torah, what you got to do throughout the years. Throughout the year, and then it says b'sheni b'chamisha b'shabbos you lay in the parshas haShavua, and then it says how do we know all this? Because it says v'daber Moshe Hashem b'nei Yisrael, that because v'daber Moshe b'nei Yisrael the me'ad Hashem Moshe Rabbeinu gave already the halachas. What's the shade v'daber Nochem v'daber Moshe? It means that you should do the kriya. And the Gemara finishes Tana Rabbanon Moshe Tikun Lehem Yisrael. She is sharing with Dushan bin Yonash of Yoim, Hilchas Pesach with Pesach, Hilchas Atzeres by Atzeres, Hilchas Chag by Chag. That Moshe was misakin that you should do the halachas of the Yom Tov on Yom Tov. So the Rebbe explains the kesher from the previous thing with Mutav Tigol Hamit Pachas to the Inya from Moshe that you should do the halachas, Hilchas Pesach with Pesach, Hilchas Chag by Chag, and so on. What's the nekuda from the mitpachas that you don't roll, you don't slip the Sefer Torah into the mitpachas? You put the mitpachas on top of the Sefer Torah. Mitpachas represents levushim, a levush, but that represents mitzvahs. So the Torah is the main thing. Godel Talmud shemevel de maisa. The first thing is Eider, Eider is a Teider. And then, and that's what the Gemara is Messiah. That how do we know the halachas? How do we know that in you from Pesach and every Shuls and Sukkot, you have to learn the halachas. The Teider is the main thing that gives you the whole foundation of the Allah halachas. So the Rebbe explains, there's a whole arichas over there, menegeya, the what means the halachas of Pesach and Pesach. If you learn the halachas from Pesach and Pesach, it's too late. That's what Alter Rebbe writes, that it has to be shloshim yom kedem machak. But there's two things. There's one thing is the halachas, and one thing the ness. In order to write about yom me'elin, iskorim v'nasim, that means that there has to be an iskorim. The iskorim is the inyan from limud ha'Torah, whatever it's in you from the Ness or the in you from the Halachas, and then it's Venasim, you can be able to do it. And that's why the Rebbe says, L'chaira, we're learning Mesechta's Megillah, the whole Megillah is Purim. Purim is known to be for mitzvahs. And the Rebbe gave like a laugh, and he says, the only place we find that instead of doing the mitzvahs of Purim and dancing is over here, Medashin, Haltenein Dashin. But the Nekuda is, Rebbe says, how does it come to in Masechtas Purim, in the Siyum of Masechtas Purim, should be discussed the Chashivas from Torah. And Rebbe says, Hogufa, when we learn the whole Masechtas Purim, you know there's the Mitzvah Mishalach Monas, Matonis Lavyenim, and so there's and those, and Chayiv Inshul Psumim Vipir, you have to dance on Purim and everything, but that has to be consumed with a concept that Godel Talmud should enable the Maisa. Hadan Allah bin Yeva Salikulam Sakh Megillah, Hadan Allah bin Yeva Salikulam Megillah, Hadan Allah bin Yeva Salikulam Sakh Megillah. 4 days.